What's going down? I'm Z-Money here from Juice Radio with the latest winner in our Fresh Coast Face Off, who goes by the humble name of Mike Phenom. Phenom has a huge following as a battle rapper and for major reasons, but I actually discovered him as an actual performer at a show at Rendezvous a couple of months ago, and Mike recently put out his mixtape, What I've Been Doing, on Bandcamp, and was featured in his track, Blessing, in the contest, when he won over Shorty, 130 to 123. But, you know, we're about to get into some things, but first, word has it you had a really rough weekend. Is your vision just starting to clean up now?
Man, I think it's still a little blurry from the influence of being Mike Phenom drunk and babysitting. The Adventures of Mike Phenom Drunk and Babysitting. That's going to be my first movie. Mike Phenom, The Adventures of Mike Phenom Drunk and Babysitting.
Can't wait to see that. Basically, this mixtape that you recently released, What I've Been Doing, it's kind of a response to what a lot of people say about you, saying, when is Mike Phenom going to drop his project? So, for real, what have you been doing?
If you look at the cover, that's pretty much it. Smoking cigarettes, laying around, man, having sex with random women and drinking. That's pretty much what I've been doing. Because, you know, like everybody, every time I always see somebody, anybody from, you know, that's a fan that's in the Seattle hip-hop scene, they always ask me, Mike, when you gonna put something up? What have you been doing? So, instead of taking that as a negative thing, I pretty much answered it just with the cover alone. So, now everybody can stop asking me what I've been doing. Like, hell, okay, so you really want to know what I've been doing? Here you go. Look, the picture's worth a thousand words. So, that was my response to that. And plus, there's a lot of things on the mixtape that that explain what I've been doing. So, you guys can go get that at mikephenom.bandcamp.com.
Yeah. All right. Like I said earlier, you're a superb battle rapper. To me, it seems like it's been a kind of lost art out here. What's your impressions on the current battle scene in the Northwest, and who else is really keeping the art going?
Well, Seattle's battle scene pretty much died probably around 04, 05. I'm pretty much the only person that's really been doing it consistently and on a national level, which is why I love it, because I get to put Seattle, you know, even though I'm not from here, I get to put Seattle I get to make people take a look in Seattle and see that it's more than just a West Coast gangster rap scene, because that's a lot of people when they hear, you know, or people, first thing that pops in people's head is Sir Mix-a-Lot. And it's more than just that out here, so I wanted to really just be the one person that's out here in a different lane, you know, keeping something going. And you're right, it is a lost art, because it's kind of like battle rapping is like the battle rapping is like the NBA slam dunk contest. And, you know, it's like before, when you watched it before, it was always like all the legends, all the super good players. Now anybody can do it. But people don't really pay attention to it. They rather, you know, watch an actual NBA game instead of just a dunk contest. So I'm a fan of slam dunk contest. So it's kind of like, they're kind of like one of the same, you know. So I try to be the slam dunk contest battle rapper, so to speak. That just really sounded weird. But that whole metaphor just really just sounded really weird how I try to compare it. But hopefully everybody listening got this and got what I was trying to say with that.
What about other artists in the area? Who have you worked with so far?
Oh, man, I've worked with quite a few artists. The first artist that I ever worked with when I got here was Aquino. Aquino was the first person that I really ever worked with. But as far as projects I've been on Nima's album. I've worked with Fatal, Spaceman, Jay Pender, Logic, Element, Second Fam, J Bars, Dice, who's also one of my very good friends. Who else have I done? I've done the homie Suede, my boy 90M from Vancouver. Man, I've worked with quite a few artists, and I've even worked with some artists that I'm not even gonna name them just because they suck, you know. But sometimes, you know, money. Hey, I'm just keeping it 100. I'm just keeping it 100. You know, sometimes you just gotta go ahead and take whatever they're paying you. You know, it's a music business. Sometimes you gotta do what you don't want to do to get where you gotta go. So I mean, I know some of those artists are probably gonna listen to this. Like, I wonder if he was talking about me. Yeah, I probably was.
Oh man, appreciate you keeping it 100 on here. But who's some people that you haven't had the chance to work with that you actually would like to?
I really want to work with Jeff Simone. That's a very good friend of mine. I'm really a big fan of her. Who else? I really want to work with Gio. I want to work with. Oh, I can't forget Language Arts. I did several tracks with Language Arts. La is probably one of my top three favorite MCs out here. Oh yeah, I worked with Brainstorm too. Time Def. Got to shout Brainstorm out. Yeah, like I really want to work. Unfortunately, D Black's not doing music anymore, but he's somebody that I definitely respect, and I really wish I could have got a chance to do some music with him. SK from Sport and Life. I want to do some music with Action Jackson and Audra from Fly Moon Royalty. They're super dope. They're over at Sport and Life too. That's pretty much it as far as people that I really look forward to collaborating with, because they all bring something different to the table, you know. And I know working with people who are in a different lane, it pretty much enhance what I'm capable of doing, and it'll open another door for me to get to where I gotta go, and you know, just becoming an overall better artist. So the only way you can really make things. Oh, I can't forget Grinch. I gotta shout out David G. You know, that's the homie. That's with Mitch and Dave. That's gonna be our song on my project, Mitch and Dave. That's what we're gonna call it. Man, I gotta shout out. Definitely gotta shout out Grinch. But yeah, that's pretty much the lineup of people that I want to see myself working with. I want to find some more really soulful artists who can bring something different to the table. I really want to. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Oh, yeah. Lace Cadence too. I keep thinking of people and forgetting people. And 84 Fly. I really want to work with 84 Fly. That's the homie. I really want to get him on my next project too. Yeah, that's gonna be a dope concept. That's gonna be a dope song if we ever get it done.
Basically, I mean, listening to you talk right there, I mean, you always got like a bunch of things on your head. It must be like part of the reason why you're so successful as a battle rapper, you think?
Yeah, I think because like I always think. That's my problem. I always think. Something's always turning in my brain. Even though like right now I'm going through like writer's block, but I always have something going on in my brain, whether it have to do with music, whether it have to do with what's going on TV, whether it has to do with me thinking, oh, who was that girl that just walked by and spoke to me? Because I still have no clue who that was. I think I know now, but I don't know. Actually, I think that my friend's neighbor that actually came over to that. Yeah, whatever. But yes, it just. I don't know, it's always something going on in my head, I'm always thinking of something funny to say. Like, if everybody could, see my facial expression while we're doing an interview, it would be so much more funnier, and it would be hilarious. You should get, a video camera and do the little HD cameras and do the interviews with those, too. That would be so dope. That'd be dope, because then everybody can get the full effect of the interview and how hot it is right now in the car. And it's just the beautiful, surrounding of Beacon Hill.
Mike Phenom on the joke, man.
Yeah. In the words of X, that matters, that Mike Phenom shit. That Mike shit, man.